Hello again, everyone. It's Todd Struch, the horror nerd, here at Scares the Care Charity Weekend 7 in Williamsburg, Virginia. It is Saturday evening at the convention. We've been rolling along all day. It's been a very busy day here. And we have a little bit of a break, so I have the great pleasure of sitting here with Miko Hughes, star of Pet Sematary, Kindergarten Cop, many other things that you're familiar with. Miko, how are you?
Doing good, Todd. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for giving us a few minutes. How's the convention been for you so far?
It's been a whirlwind. It's fantastic. Yeah, I've been trying to come to Scares That Care for quite a few years now. I've heard great things. I've seen them. They've had booths at other cons, and I was really intrigued by the cause and what they do, and heard they do their own convention. And for whatever reason, it's taken me way too long to get to this one, and I love it. Like, I can't wait to hopefully come back in the future, because that's pretty great.
Yeah, it's a great vibe. I've been working with the charity now for a long time, and I love it. And thank you, you know, for coming as a guest to support
the
charity.
Happy to be here. Of course. Yeah, thank you.
So I almost don't know where to begin, because you were a part of so many movies that I loved, you know, growing up, and as a horror fan, as a comedy fan. So you had your panel before where you gave us a little bit of an insight,
sure.
But you're only 2 years old, you know, in Pet Sematary.
Yeah.
So do you have any real solid memories of the experience? And if so, is there one in particular that stands out?
That's the tough thing, because I was so little. It's like, because it was such a big part of my life, I remember more about Pet Sematary than anything else about being that young. But I don't know if they're memories of memories, or just because the stories have been told so many times that I've held on to it more than anything else about that age. Mm. But yeah, they're like flashes. It's like pictures rather than video.
Okay,
you know?
Yeah. I get it. Mm. Do you look back now and say, my God, they let me do that stuff as a 2 year old? Or do they kind of keep you isolated? I guess they kind of keep you isolated from the real horrific elements.
Yeah, yeah. The intention was to, you know, I think Mary Lambert was really good about that. And they shot it in order so that there was time for the family to kind of build, and you see the chemistry within them. A lot of times movies are shot out of order, and
right,
I think she
right.
did that kind of intentionally, so as things go into chaos, that you're kind of the actors were experiencing it as the audience it was, really kind of discovering it as it went along. And
Cool. Yeah, and again, I keep going back to the panel, which we'll post along
panel.
With our interview.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Your comments.
I embarrassed the hell out of myself. Probably. Let's scrub that from the internet.
Your comments about your death scene, though, were hilarious.
Oh, sure.
I mean,
yeah.
Most people are completely horrified. Like, oh, my God, the death of a child.
Splat. Splat. It was roadkill. I hear it's very different when you have kids to watch that scene. That's where the impact and the weight of it comes from. So I get that. And you know, I don't have any kids that I know of, so it doesn't have that kind of impact. But I'm sure if I did, it would be take on a whole nother level. So
listen, as a dad, yeah, it's something that I thought about, you know, like it's kind of your worst nightmare, like an accident happening to your child.
Yeah.
But by the same token, I'd be like, oh, you want to play outside? All right. You know,
yeah.
Be careful.
Yeah.
Look both ways.
You kind of have to, learn. So,
Exactly. So I'm going to ask you the same question I asked you during the panel. Your famous line from Kindergarten Cop.
Boys have a penis, girls have a vagina. It's true. I verified it.
I don't know. Yeah. So I always went by what you said in the
not
film.
Not always.
Like,
not in 2021. You never know nowadays, but generally, for the most part.
So at that age, did you even really know what you were saying? Like, did you understand what it meant?
I don't think so. I knew it was something provocative that made adults laugh and like got a reaction. So I knew it was something I wasn't supposed to be saying, but I was allowed to for this like special instance. I think I didn't really fully appreciate it until much later.
And I can picture it in my head right now. I mean,
sure.
You're this adorable little kid with the bowl cut, you know, this little Moppet.
Totally.
And he says the line.
Matter of fact,
And the
Gotta
look on Arnold's face is priceless.
Sure, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, again, just these great iconic moments from the movies. Does it surprise you that after all this time, some of these movies came out decades ago, that there are fans here today, you know, lined up to meet you and to get your autograph?
Yeah, it never ceases to amaze me that something I did when I was two, here 30 some years later, I'm traveling across the country and getting to meet so many awesome people. Like, it's, I'm forever thankful. Like, it's still, it doesn't seem real a lot of times. It's pretty wild. Yeah.
I can imagine.
Sure.
So what are you working on these days? What are you, still acting? You working on any current projects?
Yeah,
what are you up to?
A little bit. I'm more behind the camera now. I work in the film department or camera department on film and production, you know, different TV, music videos, that kind of stuff. But acting wise, we're trying to do a Nightmare on Elm Street, like a new Nightmare fan film. It's had the ball rolling on it before COVID, and then COVID shut everything down. But it's kind of starting up again now. We had one of our actors is in Canada, so like flying him out, that was an issue. They're doing another round of funding on Indiegogo right now. So if anybody's interested, wants to help make it that much better, it's definitely appreciated. And that will be filming. Right now it's looking like end of the year, maybe November-ish was last I heard. But keeps getting pushed. But it is on the horizon. It is eventually going to happen. So.
Oh, that'd be great.
Yeah.
And you know what you said about moving kind of behind the scenes. I hear that a lot. You know, people who were, especially child actors, it seems.
Really? Yeah.
End up going, you know... His name escapes me, but Ralphie, you know,
yeah. Ron Howard is the most famous one, probably.
That doesn't surprise me.
Sure,
that you say
I kind of stepped away from acting in the film industry for a long time, and it was good. It was, you know, it was fine, and I learned a lot. But then I realized that I like being on set, but I don't necessarily want to act. And I think it took way too long to realize, like, you don't have to be an actor. There's plenty of other things you can do in the film industry. And, so I kind of dived into camera, and it's been a blast. I've really, really enjoyed it. I think I found a nice balance. Best of both worlds.
Good for you. We all should strive to find that in life.
Sure.
You know, with our life and our career.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Thanks.
Before we wrap it up, any last-minute thoughts about Scares the Care or anything you want to share with the viewers?
I like that rhymed, yeah. if you haven't been, check out Scares the Care. It's an awesome convention, and it has the added benefit of being, like, a really amazing cause. So, you know, anything you contribute towards it is just all the better for everyone involved, and it's a good thing.
Cool.
Yeah.
Miko, thank you so much for giving me a few minutes of your time.
Thank
it's
you.
A pleasure. I'm just a fan at heart.
Oh, well,
so
thank
the
you.
Fact that I get to do this is so cool.
Oh, you're killing it. This is
all
great.
These people that I and the films that I love. So
yeah,
I truly appreciate it.
Thank
I
you.
I wish you much success in your career and in anything that you do.
Thank you. Likewise.
And thank you. And have a great rest of the weekend here at the convention.
Sounds good.
Miko Hughes, everybody, from Pet Cemetery here at Scares That Care Charity Weekend 7 in Williamsburg, Virginia. I am the horror nerd, Todd Struch, signing off. And we will see all of you in the next interview.